you are here with us on today. And Reverend Miller always does a wonderful job, a great friend, amen, and we really appreciate him. I want to let you know that just in case there's anyone, I think everybody has already taken care of it, but just in case there's anyone who hasn't seen the table when you come in, you'll get a stub. There's going to be a raffle later. If you don't have your stub, then you need to see the ticket table. And if you haven't taken care of it yet, you can also do that while you're there, because you should have a stub, and that stub is for the raffle. So at this time, we're going to ask for Lady Pagan to come, and amen, she's going to, amen, do the prayer, the invocation to bless the food and to bless the service.
Amen. Amen.
First, I just want to give honor to God. Yes. 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 Ahead of my life. Yes. Yes. I would like to say I thank and praise God for being in your midst one more Mother's Day prayer breakfast.
Amen.
I thank and I praise God for being saved and sanctified and baptized and filled with the gift of the Holy Ghost.
All right.
I thank and I praise God for Jesus today.
Yes.
So if everyone will bring their minds on in, we'll get started.
Thank you, Lady Pagan. Amen.
Amen.
Now at this time, you're going to receive a welcome from our very own First Lady, Denise Tillman.
Everybody looks so beautiful. All the mothers look so beautiful. All the men look so dapper on this morning. Praise God. We'd like to welcome you to Jeremiah Temple's pre-Mother's Day prayer breakfast. Amen.
Amen.
At Cancer Crusade. We'd like to welcome you to our Mother's Day celebration, celebrating all the mothers on today.
Amen.
Prepare yourselves as the table is spread and the feast of the Lord is going on.
Amen.
You are welcome once, you're welcome twice, you're welcome in the wonderful and matchless name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
I want to thank you, First Lady Tillman, for that wonderful welcome. Amen. We want to let those who are stricken with cancer, we want to let them know that there is help, there are resources, and that we're standing behind you in prayer and spiritual support.
Yes.
And so God gave me this several years ago, and every year we've been doing it since, that we have the Mother's Day prayer breakfast to honor all the beautiful mothers, and then we also want to be a support to those who are going through cancer. Those who are receiving chemo, those who are receiving radiation, it looks like you're not going to come through. It looks like you're not going to be well. But that's just false evidence appearing real. We can't have fear when we belong to the body of Christ. Because we know with God, we can do all things. All things are possible with God. Everyone who is able to stand, I want you to just stand in love. I want you to stand in support. I want you to stand because I want you to know that even though you might be going through some trials and tribulations, I want you to know this morning, you don't have to go through it alone. I want you to know this morning that you need to fight.
Amen.
And I want to thank you for joining the fight against cancer. We must fight. He wrestled with the angel all night long and said, I won't let you go till you bless me. He showed us that we need to fight. There's so many other examples, but you are worth fighting for.
Yes.
Your brother is worth fighting for. Your sister is worth fighting for. Your mother is worth fighting for.
God is able to do just what he said. He's able. Can I get a witness? He's able. How God is able. He'll pick you up, turn you around, and
Pastor, for your invitation. First Lady, God bless you. First Lady, yes, I apologize. Make sure you get the First Lady right. Always make sure you get the First Lady right. It's important. It's really important. As it has been stated, my name is Reverend Percy McCray, and I am the National Director of Spiritual Programming for the Cancer Treatment Centers of America corporate office, the first of its appointment within a healthcare system in the United States. And so I am privileged to stand before you here very quickly. I received a phone call invitation from your pastor and asked if I would be willing to come and just say a few quick things to you around cancer awareness, some numbers, and ultimately the message of that cancer is beatable, cancer is treatable, and cancer is survivable. Can I get a couple of amens?
Yeah.
That's what Pastor just stated.
Minister Selena Hampton, put your hands together. Amen.
Good afternoon.
God bless everyone. Before I begin, I would first like to give honor to God, who's the head of my life.
Yes. Amen.
I would like to give honor to my shepherd, Pastor Claymore.
Yes. Amen.
Honor to Pastor Taylor and his wife.
Praise the Lord.
And honor to all other ministers and evangelists and elders that's here in this place. I give honor to you and brothers and sisters in Christ as well.
Yes.
I consider it an honor to come before you. I pray that I move in the Holy Spirit and that I'm obedient in what it is that the pastor has asked me to do.
Yes.
And that I just follow under the anointing of God.
Praise the Lord. Amen.
As I come before you, before I start, I would first like to pray.
Yes.
And we all know this is a prayer bunch, so we should have expected some prayer. I'm asking if you will stand in agreement with me as we pray to our Father and ask him that he decrease my flesh.
Yes.
And that the Holy Spirit begin to rise up in me.
Yes, Lord.
And that the Holy Spirit begin to rise up in this place.
Yes,
and
Lord.
In you as well. We're praying for open ears today and not deaf ears. We're praying, Lord God, for an open mind and a listening mind. And we're praying, Lord God, for an unhardened heart on today, Lord God. I'm asking, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, that your people not see me, Lord God, but they
you
see
him today. Our funny man, who is also a preacher, who is also a pastor, who is widely known as the storyteller. Put your hands together and receive Pastor James T. Ford as he comes.
And I got to say this before I go any further. I thank God because this is about survivors.
That's right.
And many people don't know my testimony. In 2005, at August the 8th of 2005, I got diagnosed with cancer in 4 spots in my body. The doctor said, what are you going to do? Are you going to do radiation or are you going to do surgery? And I stood there and I said, God, what's the next move? What's the next step? Yeah. And can I give you a rhema word? The power of God.
Yeah.
See, the Bible said life and death are on the tips of the tongue.
Yeah.
When I didn't know what to do and didn't know how to do it and nowhere to go. And everybody around me was kicking out and checking out. A woman called me from Ohio. She said, Elder Ford, I wasn't pastoring then. She said, Elder Ford, the Lord told me to tell you. Quote the 118th division of Psalms and the 17th verse. I shall not die, but live to declare the works of the Lord. And I tell people everywhere I go, the reason I love him, because when I'm hungry, he cultivates.
Come on, man.
When I'm thirsty, he irrigates. When I'm lonely, he appreciates. When I'm bored, he fascinates. When I get sick, he medicates. When I get moneyless, he donates. When I get shelterless, he accommodates. When I get weak, he invigorates. When I get in trouble, he investigates. And when the devil comes around, he makes the devil vacate because he is my advocate.
I understand. I know what's going on sometimes. You know, to those who are not able to do it today, you wanted that don't shoot t-shirt, but you couldn't do it today. You wanted that cancer t-shirt, but you couldn't do it today. You wanted to give in the cancer offering, but you couldn't do it today. Well, that's all right. Take your program with you, and our address is on there. Our phone number is on there. You can contact us next week after you cash in your lottery ticket.
Deep in my despair to show me you would never leave me there. You claim because I was made for so much more. I am your child, and I'm worth fighting for. Oh, heavy with the weight of my mistakes, you carried me and refused to let me sink under the pressure. You meant for me to soar. I am your child, and I'm worth fighting for. Eyes haven't seen, ears haven't heard all you have planned for me, and nothing can separate me from your love when there's so much more still worth fighting for. Now I'm moving by faith and not by sight towards victory. By the power of your might, you're straightening out my path and opening every door. I am your child,